Thank you very much, and good morning, everyone, and very kind introduction today. I'd like to talk about the urban mining development on the critical metal from WEEE. So the keywords, the two keywords, urban mining and critical metals. So the outline here, the brief introduction, the urban mining, and also the critical metals, and technology. I showed the technology using the urban mining from the R project. And finally, the conclusion here. So the probably that someone see this figure. This one is from the UNEP report. General concept, the coupling between the economic activity and the resource and resource use and environment impact. Of course, the it's better to okay, sorry. it's better the decoupling the between the economic activity, the resource use, and also especially in the environmental impact. So the how we can achieve this decoupling. So one of the way is the recycling. So of course, recycling should contribute to reducing the environmental impact, including energy consumption and natural resource consumption, both. That's very important. So the this figure showed the supply chain of resources. About 30 years ago, the Professor Nanjo, it's the same institute of I belong the Tohoku University. So the he said he showed this figure and from the natural resources, especially this figure focused on metals. We produce primary metals and also the make a device and make a parts and final products, it's such as cars and home appliances, something, and we use and we have the waste and collect and recycling. Of course, some of them to disposal. And each stage, we have a scrap or waste. So we have to recycle the each stage. So the this supply chain, we consider the very important point is the recycling and also the one kind of waste treatment. That's the environment, keep the good environment. So the this figure shows the comparison, the urban mine development and normal mine development. So the natural ore mining at first exploration and feasibility study for mining and mineral dressing and extraction. So our mining at first we have to do where is the target metals or materials. So the at first we have to investigate material flow analysis. And after that, planning for the collection, that's the considering this social system. And that's it's the same for the feasibility study for the mining. And mining is a collection. And mineral dressing is a pre-treatment. We say pre-treatment, mainly the physical separation. And extraction parts, it's not so big different. So that also is very, very important. That means the we have already the smelter and the refinery, so the, we can use them. So how we can develop the urban mining? We always have to consider both social system and technologies at the same time. Social system include material flow analysis and the collection system. This part looks like and strategy. And the free trade economy sometimes doesn't work. So we need the law, recycling law. Here in the Europe, WEEE and the ERB directive, ERB recycle directive, I don't know the exact name. And also in Japan, we have the ERB recycling law and home appliance recycling law, food and construction materials, and yeah, so the we need the law. So the and also the technology, the new technology have also needed for new complex resources. The later I showed the very high complex products. So we need the new technology. So this part, especially for the pretreatments, dismantle, crushing, and physical separation, this part looks like the tactics. So, and also it's very important here, infrastructure, which we have already had, should be used efficiently. Many smelter and refinery have already worked for the metals, and also the steelworks we have. So it's better to use them. So I change the next keyword, the critical metals. So what is the critical metals? So the critical metals are key element for advanced materials, and we need the critical metals to high quality life. That means the low the emission, the carbon dioxide, the save energy. Yeah. So one example here is the rare earth magnet for motor. It's tremendously the effect for the reduce the consumption of the energy. So we need the dispersion. It's very special rare earth. And also for the cutting tool, we need the tungsten. And for the phosphor, the terbium, the europium. And also here, the catalyst, we need the platinum and the cerium. So these are all the critical metals. So it's very, very important now. And also same way the we use some very high performance HEV. So of course the main part materials, the steel, aluminum, copper, the basic base metals, and also the plastic and the CFRP, so on. But to produce this car, we need the many rare earth element and also the platinum group metals to keep high quality in the environment. So almost 5 years ago, we had a little bit serious problem to supply of the rare earth and also the critical metals. So we start the meeting between the EU, US, Japan, and about the how to achieve the stable supply of the critical metals. So the last year, September, it was held in the Ames in the Iowa in the United States. This is the fourth time. So the content here, and this year, the October and the fifth EU US Japan Trilateral Conference on Critical Metal will be held in Japan. Now we are preparing. Okay, so we need to recycling the critical metals. Now it's moved to the technologies, especially from our project. So our project here, the name is our project, High Efficiency Rare Elements Extraction Technology Area in Tohoku Innovative Materials Technology Initiative for Reconstruction. So reconstruction means from the very serious damage of the earthquake. We had the very serious earthquake 2011, and also the tsunami. The coast side, the north Japan, it's a very serious the damage, especially in the Fukushima. Still, we have a problem with the nuclear power plant. So we need the new industrial innovation. So and the Japanese government choose one of them, it's a recycling. So they allowed us the study, a very basic study about the recycling. So now I'll introduce some of them. This research of subjects on physical separation of the WEEE, development of novel breakdown technology. We say electric disintegration technique. Yesterday, do you remember the Professor Motivenga explained this almost same, they showed the same picture. He said the high voltage pulse fragmentations. Yeah, we say the electric disintegration technique. So, and the another one is the development of the LIMS sorter. So for the recycling, we becomes very popular the using the sorting machine. So sensor part, it depends on the what kind of the materials we want to divide, but using the color, shape, and also the infrared and X-ray, so on. So this time, we use a laser to analyze the chemical composition. So at first, I showed the electrical disintegration technique. So we applied the high voltage pulse in the water. We have two disintegration power, the electric hydraulic disintegration, and the another one, the direct electric disintegration, the solid. So in case of this one, in the pulse running, high voltage pulse running the interface between the different phase. So very easy to separate the phase. So this is one of the example how to separate. So using this technique, for example, in the isotope, normal crushing process, it's very difficult to, not like this, but we can get the material which are used in the tips and plastic here. So easy, very easy to separate after that. And also this is a very special printed circuit board with the ceramic capacitors. So we can separate from we can separate the ceramic capacitors from the printed circuit board. No damage of the ceramic capacitors. It's a very small size, only 1 to 2 millimeter. So we tried to print circuit board of the ELV, the engine computer, and we have these kind of products. And here is also the ceramic capacitors. And the print circuit board around 10 ppm of the palladium content. But after we detached the ceramic capacitors, the palladium content increased up to around 3%. So easy to evaluate. Yeah. So it looks good. And next is the rim sorter. So just under construction, the rim sorter. Here is a laser spectrometer and 3D shape detector and sampling inlet and the paddle. So after the construction and this sorter set in the laboratory, the width, the belt conveyor is 300 millimeter and moving speed at 2 meters per second. Yeah. So it's very difficult to see, but you can see the spectrum. And so we can identify the elements. Now it's our system identify these elements. So why we choose the elements? One reason that we focus on the tantalum capacitors in the print circuit, on the print circuit board. Anyway, just now the very early stage prototype. So the next stage, and we developed more good and high speed and stable rim sorter. So the next one, the chemical extraction parts. We focused one of the target. It's ionic rickets for the extraction of the critical metals. Especially in this case, in our case, it's especially they focused on the rare earth element and niobium and dysprosium and PZM and platinum group metals. So so today I don't have enough time to explain this part, but we succeed to the estimate how the ionic rickets work to extraction the rare earth element, especially in niobium and dysprosium, using this type of the ionic rickets, cation and anion. And we use a simulation technique, almost the first principle technique, so the theory, so the only the little bit of thermodynamic data used for the calculation, but we succeed. Oh, of course, we have done the experiment. It works. It's good. So these are the conclusion remarks, but I skipped. So if you have any question, please contact here and one more. So these are not two more. This is acknowledgement. I do appreciate Professor Shiratori at Tohoku University and Harada at NIMS in Japan for the useful discussion and the finance support from financial support from the Ministry of Education, the Science, Culture, and the Sport in Japan. So and also this is the last one. Last year, no? Yep, last year, we published the Urban Mind System from the Springer. So if you have any the interest, and please go to this site, so you can download. But of course, you need you have to pay something for the Springer. Okay, so thank you very much for your kind attentions.
Thank you very much, Professor Nakamura. We have the time for questions. I can start. In the different method you are developing, what is the sensitivity? For example, for the you develop physical and chemical method. For the chemical method, for instance, what is the sensitivity to separate material? What is the minimum quantity of one material in a system you can extract?
It's very difficult question because then we need the total system from the physical separation to the chemical separation. And also it depends on the metals. Yeah, so rare earths, or PGM. So, but in case of this, it's very high the sensitivity or the selectivity to the rare earth element to the other metals. It's very high, yeah. And so the actually it's very difficult to show how good sensitivity or the selectivity the compounds showed. It's depend on the condition, yeah. So it's very difficult to say, but I believe the this and the ionic rickets compound the works very well. Now it's we try to synthesize the a little large amount. Yeah, it's not so easy. Okay, sorry.
Thank you for your great presentation. I have just one simple and your expert questions. I'm the answers. For the next maybe 5 years, now and for the next 5 years, what are your very important or very valuable target elements out of many rare elements in your Japan, maybe in the world, and then what are the to get extract those very important and valuable rare elements? Are there any specific equipment or target product that you wanna get? Maybe mobile phone. I don't know. So, okay.
I believe the next, or not the not next, it's already, and also the future, it's the PGM. It's very, very important. And of course, we use and catalyze, and not only car, the energy combustion, if we can use enough PGM group metals, it's very easy to get a good result. So now so many researchers try to find the new catalyzer, except use the PGM. Yeah. And as you know, now it's the supply of the critical metals not so severe now. It's because then the economy is not so good now all over the world. So the demand it's decreased. So the not so severe, but the probably next 10 years economic activity increase. And so the for the, we have the same situation the last 2 or 3 years. So we have to do the recycling. Yeah. And also one more thing. I have to say one more. So the social system and technology, it's very, very important. The harmonization, it's very important. And especially in the social system, it's depend on the area, the countries. So it's depend on the culture. So it's not the general answer. It's very difficult to generalize. Yeah. So each country or each area have each system, and harmonization with technologies.